morning students. Here already we complete the third unit syllabus in Python programming language. Next unit is unit 4 syllabus ma. In this syllabus we are having dictionaries, tuples, files and classes and objects. These are the four chapters we have to learn in this unit ma. Here first, in this dictionaries we are having some of the topics. Dictionary is a mapping, dictionary is a collection of counters, next looping and dictionaries, reverse lookup, dictionaries and list, memos, global variables. Next, tuples. In the tuples, tuples are immutable, tuple assignment, tuple as written values, variable length argument tuples, list and tuples, dictionaries and tuples, sequence of sequence. Next one, files. In these files, persistence, reading and writing, format operator, file name and paths, catching exceptions, databases, pickling, pipes, writing modules. These are the topics come under the files. Next, classes and objects. In this class and objects, you have to learn about the programmer defined types, attributes, instances as written values, and objects are mutable, copying, classes and functions. These are the topics come under the class and objects. Next, first, what is meant by the dictionaries here? Here, in this Python dictionary, it is a container of the unordered set of objects like list. Here, in generally, in dictionary, we have with alphabets values, we have some of the meanings of that words. So likewise here in Python programming language also, it is a container of the unordered set of objects like list. Here these objects, these are surrounded by the curly braces. Next, in this dictionaries we are having some of the elements. These elements are comma separated. In these values are these items. It is list of like key value pair. In this dictionary, keys and values are Python data type. They are the Python data type. Key value pair. We are giving the key value, key for that key. The value is the pair of that key value pair. Now pairs, these are comma separated list. Here next point is each object or value accessed by key, and keys are unique in the dictionary. Next, keys are used for indexing. Here they must be immutable type. Here in this immutable type means string, number or tuple. These are the immutable types. Here keys are used for indexing. They must be the immutable type. Here string, number or tuple. These are the immutable types. Next point. Here the function dict is a keyword here. Dict creates a new dictionary with no items. Here dict is a keyword. The function dict creates a new dictionary with no items. Because dict is the name of a built-in function. How to create some of the dictionary? And then we are using the dict keyword here. Here dict is the name of a built-in function. Built-in function means already predefined function. Next point is create an empty dictionary using empty curly braces. How to create a dictionary? First, you have to create the empty dictionary. Dict equal to curly brackets open, curly brackets close. That is the empty dictionary. In the dictionary, you have to insert the values. Next, for example, you have to create a new dictionary in Python. have to create a new dictionary in Python. This is the code ma in Python, empty dictionary. How to create like this? New dict, D-I-C-T, dict equal to dict. New dict equal to dict. Here new dict equal to empty curly brackets, bracket open, bracket close. Here you have to print, the new dict, what is the output here? Curly bracket open, curly bracket close. Here these brackets are also called as the squiggly brackets, these brackets also known as the squiggly brackets. These brackets represent an empty dictionary. These brackets represent an empty dictionary. Next example here, dictionary with key value. This is the key value pair ma. You have to create the dictionary color. COLOR, color. Color equal to dictionary name here. This is the, in this dictionary, create, we have to create by the, in curly brackets only. In these curly brackets, we have key value pairs. In this color, equal to color 1. Color 1 tends to red. Color 1: red. This is the one key value. In that call 1, when this call 1, we have red color. Next. Call 2. In that green color. We save the green color. Next, call 3. Orange color. O-R-A-N-G-E. Orange color. Means we have call 1 red, call 2 green, call 3 orange. Means we have, these are the key value pairs. You have to print call 1, the output is red color. Likewise here we have to print the color here. This is the, you have to create the color in this color, in this dictionary color, call 1, call 2, call 3. Here you have to print the color. What is the output means here? First call 2 will be printed. Means here, this is the, in this dictionary also, in this dictionary, in generally dictionary we have in alphabetical order. Likewise in Python programming language, dictionary, in this dictionary also it printed like alphabetical order. Here in this call 2, first call 2 in this green color, next call 3, next orange, next call 1, red color. Likewise, have to print like that. Next, this is the output for the above program. This is the key value pair. Next point is, how to get value by key in Python dictionary. How to declare a dictionary. Here, for example, we take dict equal to 1:20.5, 2:3.03, 3:23.22, 4:33.12. Here have to access the key by using value. Here keys are 1, 2, 3, 4. These are the keys. Values are 20.5, 3:03, 23.22, 33.12. These are the values for that keys. Here dict of 1. Means in this one we have 20.5. That is the output for that. How to access value by using key. How to print 1. Dict of 1. We got 20.5. Here dict of 3. What is the value? What is the output for that? 23.22. Suppose dict of 4. In the dict of 4 we have 33.12. The output is 33.12. Next, another point is here, accessing value using get method. By using get method also we have to access the value here. Dict of get 1. 20.5. Dict of get 3, 23.22. By using get method also you have to access the value from dictionary. Next, Next point is how to add key value to a dictionary in Python. How to add key value to a dictionary in Python. Here first you have to declare a dictionary with single element. How to declare a dictionary with a single element. You have dict equal to pdy1 colon dictionary. Pdy1 colon dictionary. Here in this pdy1 colon dictionary, only one key value pair only in this dictionary have. How to add this is also a facility in Python. How to add key value to a dictionary, how to add that. That's why dictionary is the immutable data, immutable type. Here pdy1 colon dictionary, that is the you have to print dict. In this dict the output is pdy1 colon dictionary. Next how to add this dictionary. How this is a single element, but how to add second another element also, another key value also. Here dict of pdy2 equal to string, dict of pdy2 equal to string. Print dict. In this print dict the output is pdy1 dictionary comma pdy2 colon dictionary string colon string. Pdy1 dictionary pdy2 colon string. This is also one of the point here. How to add key value to a dictionary in Python. How to add the elements also in the dictionary in Python. Next. By using update method, you have to add key value pairs also. By using update method to add key value pairs in the dictionary. Here d equal to 0 colon 10, 1 colon 20, print of d. In this the output is 0 colon 10, 1 colon 20. This is the output for this above program. Here d dot update method, by using this update method to add key value pairs in the dictionary. Next d dot update two colon 30. You have to print d. The output is 0 colon 10, 1 colon 20, 2 colon 30. By using this method to add key value pairs into the dictionary. Next point is the len function. Len. Another function name is len function. This function works on dictionaries. It returns the number of key value pairs. Len of color. Already we create the dictionary color. In that color, we have three key value pairs. How to find out the length of color. In this length of color, the output is 3. Len function, it works on the dictionaries. It returns the number of key value pairs. Already we create the color dictionary. In this color dictionary, we have 3 key value pairs. That's output is 3. Next, the in operator works on dictionaries. Here call one in color. In this color dictionary we have call one is there, and that's why it is true. Color four in color. In this color dictionary, the call four is not having. That's why the output is false. Next, the IN operator by uses different algorithms for list and dictionaries. Here the IN operator uses different algorithms, means in that list it is available or not. It is available or not. Here for list it uses say search algorithm. Here the IN operator uses the different algorithms for list and dictionaries. Here for list the IN operator uses a search algorithm. Next, for dictionaries, Python uses an algorithm called a hash table. Python uses an algorithm called a hash table. Here, the IN operator takes about the same amount of time. The IN operator takes the about the same amount of time. Here, how many items there are in a dictionary? Next topic is dictionary has a set of counters. We are given a string and we want to count how many times each letter appears in the dictionary. There are several ways we could do it here. We could create 26 variables. One for each letter of the alphabet. Here, then we could traverse this string. We could create 26 variables, one for each letter of the alphabet. Then we could traverse this string and for each character increment the corresponding counter. Probably by using a chained conditional. Here, next point is we could create a list with 26 elements. Then we could convert each character to a number. For example, A, 1, B, 2, likewise. We could create a list with 26 elements. Then we could convert each character to a number by using a built-in function ORD. Next, use the number as an index into the list. And how to increment the appropriate counter. Next, we are given a string. We want to count how many times each letter appears here. There are several ways. We could create 26 variables for each letter for the alphabet. Here, have to traverse the string and for each character and increment the corresponding counter by using the chained conditional. Next, third point is we could create a dictionary with the characters. We could create a dictionary with characters as keys and counters as the corresponding values. Next, the first time you see a character, we would add an item to a dictionary. After that, we would increment the value of an existing item. Next. Here, these are the options how to count the letters in the dictionary. Each of these options performs the same computation, but here each of them implements the in different ways. Here, in this implementation, it is the way of performing a computation. Some implementations are better than others here. Next point is an advantage of the dictionary implementation. implementation is that you don't have to know ahead of time which letters appear in the string, and we only have to make room for the letters that do appear. Here, what is the advantage of the dictionary implementation? Means we don't have to know ahead of time which letters appear in the string, what are the letters that appear in the string, and we only have to make room for the letters that do appear. Here, this is the example ma for this. Here what is the code means here? Def histograms. Histograms are used in statistics. Here d equal to dict for c in s. Here next, if c not in d, on the time d of c equal to 1, else d of c plus c equal to 1, written d here. The name of the function is histogram, it is a statistical term for a set of counters. It is a statistical term for a set of counters or frequencies. Next. Example is the first line of the function creates an empty dictionary. Here, first line of a function creates an empty dictionary. The loop for loop as it traverses the string. Next, each time through a loop here, if the character C is not in the dictionary, in the time we create a new item with key C and initial value 1. Here, since we have seen this letter once, if C is already in the dictionary, we increment D of C. Here's how it works like this. That is the code ma. Here, what is the example here? Here, we create a new item with key C. The initial value is 1. Here, if C is already in the dictionary, we increment C, increment of C. Here, likewise, here, how it works means here, H equal to histogram. In that histogram, we have brontosaurus. We give some word here, print H. Here, like this, A, one time, B, one time, next O, two times. How many alphabets there in the that word? C is in dictionary, increment C value. But here in this output, in this program, don't have C value. Here in this histogram, repeated 1, next B only 1, O 2, next N 1, next S 2, R 2, next U 2, next T 1. This indicates the letters A and B appear only A B appear once, O appears twice. For example, we take here, dictionaries have a method that called get. It takes a key and a default value. Next, if the key appears in the dictionary, it returns the corresponding value. Otherwise, it returns a default value. For example, H equal to histogram of A. Print H. A equal to 1. H dot get A comma 0. We got the value 1. Means we have A equal to 1. Next, H dot get B comma 0. B comma 0. The output is 0. Means B have, don't have value for that. Next. Otherwise, it is print H. A equal default value. Here, what is the facility in this? What is the use of this means here? Dictionaries have method called get that takes a key and a default value here. If the key appears in the dictionary, it returns the corresponding value. Otherwise, it returns the default value. Here, H equal histogram of A. Only key value is there. Value is not key. Only key is there. Value is not there. That's why it takes the A:1. It takes the default 1. Default 1. Next. Here, H dot get of A comma 0. Means we got the A value is 1. A value is 1. Next, B value is 0. Value is 0. Next. Next point is, next topic is looping and dictionaries. Looping and dictionaries. Here, if we use a dictionary in a first statement, already we know about looping statements, for loop, while loop, like that. In this looping and dictionaries, we are having. In that having, if we use a dictionary in a for loop, for statement, it traverses the keys of the dictionary, the keys of the dictionary. Example, for example, D equal to red 1, green 2, blue 3. For key, for color key value in D term, D items, D dot items. For key value, key come, for color of key, value in D dot items. Here color key corresponds to like this. Here green color corresponds to 2, red color corresponds to 1, blue color corresponds to 3. That is the use of the looping and dictionaries. We use the looping statements likewise in the, like this in dictionaries. Here we use this in first statement. It traverses the keys of the dictionary. It traverses the keys of the dictionary. D, red 1. Green 2, blue 3, for color key value in the D items. Next, print hist prints each key and corresponding value. Define print hist of H. Print hist of H. Here for C in H. Print C comma H of C. Here, what's the output look like? Means here, H equal to histogram of parrot. Here, H equal to histogram of parrot. Here, print hist. Already, print hist about the, already we defined the function. Defined this function here. Here, first, parrot. Output is A, 1, P, 1. Means A letter repeated only 1, P repeated only 1, R repeated 2, O repeated 1, T repeated 1. Likewise, you have to print. Means print hist prints each key value, each key and corresponding value. Or define the print, this is the function name. Or already we defined this function. In this function, for C in H, print C of H of C. Here, H equal to histogram of parrot. Here, print hist of H. In this H, we have parrot is there. Parrot is there, likewise.